Great.
So the electric power conditions in India. In India, the demand of electricity is more than the supply. So out of the 1.4 billion people worldwide who have no access to electricity, India accounts for over 300 million. The burning of fossil fuels creates greenhouse gases, such as carbon dioxide and methane. India uses an ample of fossil fuels as we have to supply a large population. An alternative to fossil fuels could be bioalcohol. This is a method in which alcohol and ethanol are used to create fuel. However, some of the ethanol is derived from petroleum and should not be considered safe for use. Ethanol gas absorbs water and holds the moisture in a fuel tank, which increases the occurrence of water diluted fuel. A safer and more convenient alternative is using biofuels. This gas is made from organic waste, so it is good for India's agriculture economy. The Jatropha is highly cultivated in India, which is used to create the biofuel. As there is a lot of population and traffic in India, biofuels are an environmentally safe option as they are low polluting.
Thank you. Can I just make a request here? Is it possible for you to move this, the screen which is showing us, and move it to the side? No, that's not. We can't do it.
Where do you want it to be moved?
Maybe towards the bottom. Bottom right? Or can I just...
So the screen is
this.
Yeah, we're just doing that.
All right, thank you.
Is it any better now?
Hey, that's much better. Now we can read it. Before it was, it was just hiding all the writing. That's it. Thank you so much.
Okay, so why is biofuels the most viable solution, especially for a country like India? Now, in Mumbai alone, which is our city, we generate 70,000 tons of waste in 1 year, and our city has 21 million people. Most Indian households, they still do not segregate their wet and dry waste, and this waste is dumped into the dumping ground, and it decays there very, very slowly. Now, this decomposed bacteria produces the greenhouse gases like methane and carbon dioxide, and this plays a huge role in the greenhouse effect also. Now, a lot of fires, especially in Mumbai, occur in these dumping grounds as methane is highly flammable. An example of this could be last year in the Deonar dumping ground, which is in Mumbai. There was a series of fires in this, as a result of which the city was enveloped in smog. Now,
yes, ma'am, what was it?
No, if it's good from us, it's fine.
Okay,
keep going.
Okay.
So, in addition to the air pollution problems, a study in 2007 shows that the discharge of untreated sewage is the single most important cause for pollution of the groundwater in India. And also the uncollected waste accumulates in the urban areas, and this causes unhygienic conditions and the release of heavy metals and pollutants that leaches the surface of and groundwater. Now let's move to the rural areas. We just spoke about the urban areas. Now India is an agriculturally based economy, and we have an abundance of livestock, and animals like cows are domesticated in large numbers for milk. And these animals are also used as a means of transportation. So there is an abundance of biomass, and plant remains after harvesting grains, animal dung, fruit, vegetable, and the poultry.
Okay.
the tradition used in India for biomass is basically we use most of the wood agricultural waste like cow dung cakes for cooking and general heating needs. These traditional fuels are burnt in cooking stoves known as chulas up here. In addition to this, we use traditional and artisan industries too. Now the problems associated with the traditional use of biomass are like they are inefficient source of energy due to its low calorific value. On burning, it releases a lot of smoke, causing a lot of harmful elements in the air like carbon monoxide, which basically affects the population of India. As the WHO